Big Top Burger is a gosh darn masterpiece, and you need to watch it. The whole show is only 10 minutes long, it's free to view on YouTube, and it is a shining beacon of heart, humor, and joy in the burning trash heap of a year that has been 2020. The voice acting rocks, the music rocks, the animation rocks, and the writing rocks. And it is the mind-bogglingly effective writing of Big Top Burger that we'll be diving into today, as we examine a brief clip from Big Top Burger's first episode, Stove. The episode opens with a customer ordering a simple burger. Yet as Penny, one of the food truck's employees, soon learns, the truck stove has been completely ripped from the wall and dragged into the front of the cab by the owner of the food truck, Steve. When the crew goes to investigate, here's what happens.
Steve, what are you doing?
Preparing some treats for my daughter's bake sale, of course.
Oh, wow, sir. I didn't know you had a daughter.
I don't think he does. Steve, man, the stove's not even plugged into anything.
Is that a customer I see?
A lot just happened in those 15 seconds, so let's break this scene down beat by beat to fully appreciate its genius. First, Billy asks Steve what he is doing, to which he replies,
Preparing some treats for my daughter's bake sale, of course.
Now, this is the first time we hear Steve speak in the entire series, and his high-pitched giggle indicates that his voice would be similarly high-pitched. Yet when he speaks, his voice is, well, not high-pitched. The contrast between Steve's childish giggle and his mature, gravelly voice is extremely jarring and surprisingly funny. That is joke number one. Next, let's examine what Steve actually says here. He says that he's preparing some treats for his daughter's bake sale, but the items on the tray are rocks, which decidedly cannot be baked. That is joke number two. Also, as Tim soon points out, the stove isn't plugged in, so even if Steve was baking some treats, he wouldn't be accomplishing anything. That is joke number three. Then, when Penny exclaims that she didn't know Steve had a daughter, Tim retorts that he doesn't think Steve does have a daughter. That is joke number four. So, to recap, Steve ripped the stove out of the wall, lugged it into his office, put some rocks on a baking tray, and attempted to cook those rocks for his daughter's bake sale. Despite the fact that rocks are inedible, despite the fact that the stove had, at that moment, no capacity to bake things that are edible, and despite the fact that Steve's daughter does not exist! And to top it all off, Steve notices a customer standing outside the food truck and teleports to the truck's window, having entirely forgotten any of his previous motivation to prepare treats for his non-existent daughter's non-existent bake sale. That is joke number five. So in just 15 seconds, Big Top Burger delivered five hilarious jokes. I think I can only begin to fathom how series creator Ian Worthington managed to conceive of a situation that was so laden with humor, nevertheless to execute on that situation so well. But if I had to pin it down, I think it's due to Big Top Burger's use of absurd comedy. The more you think about this scene and the further that you attempt to dissect it, the funnier it becomes, because Steve's motivation is genuinely beyond any sense of logic or rationality. Despite how entrenched Steve is into the delusion of his daughter's bake sale, he then discards that delusion immediately upon noticing a customer, who, by the way, he proceeds to pull a fully cooked burger out of his hat for. This show is just so goddamn good. This is far from the only joke in the series like this, but it felt like the best example to highlight here. If you haven't already, please, please, please check out Big Top Burger, as it is an absurdly unique, startlingly hilarious, and surprisingly heartfelt work of animation. Until next time, thank you for watching, like and subscribe and all that nonsense, and if you don't watch Big Top Burger, I will rip your stove out of your wall and use it to prepare some treats for my daughter's bake sale.
Brush my hair, read my eyes.